water, 10 gallon Stetson, and a horse that bears my brand. 1,000-headed cattle on a great big piece of land. I want a ranch in Arizona where they never sleep inside. I want to gaze at the moon and stars above. I want to learn to rope and ride. I want 2 pearl-handled 6 guns, the kind that really shoot. A saddle trimmed with silver and a pair of yellow boots. I'll have my name carved on my belt. I'll line my saddle, see with felt. I'm gonna be a cowboy, yes, siree. Bears my brand. 1,000-headed cattle on a great big piece of land. I want a ranch in Arizona where they never sleep inside. I want to gaze at the moon and stars above. I want to learn to rope and ride. I want 2 pearl-handled 6 guns, the kind that really shoot. Saddle trimmed with silver and a pair of yellow boots. I'll have my name carved on my belt. I'll line my saddle, see with felt. I'm gonna be a cowboy, yes siree.
Out of the West to you comes the music all America's talking about. Western Swing, brought to you by the king of Western Swing,
Cowboy Joe.
Woo-hoo! Oh boy, here it comes again. My favorite song, that old ragtime country cowboy Joe.
The music to the cattle as he swings back and forward in the saddle on a horse. Daddy sing the baby crazy, then the such a funny meter to the road of his defeat, a hard and wrong. When the fella gone for the western folks, oh no, he's a highfalutin, losing suit, son of a gun from Arizona, ragtime cowboy Joe. In Arizona where the bad men are, the only thing to guide you is the evening star. The roughest, toughest man by far is ragtime cowboy Joe. He got his name for singing to the cows and sheep. Every night the same seems to herd to sleep with a voice that's rich and deep. He's crooning soft and low. He always sings,
he always sings,
ragging music to the cattle as he swings,
as he swings,
back and forward in the saddle on a horse. Better syncopated, gated, and the such a funny meter to the roar of his repeat, how they run,
how they run,
when the fellas here is gone, for the western folks all know,
what do they know?
Well, he's a highfalutin, rootin', tootin', son of a gun from Arizona, ragtime cowboy Joe. Sing, ragging music to the cattle as he swings, back and forward in the saddle on a horse. Fanny sing a fade a gator, and the such a funny meets through the roars and feet are rather wrong. When a fellow here is down for the western folks all know, he's a highfalutin, rootin' tootin', son of a gun from Arizona, ragtime cowboy Joe.
All you rednecks out there, stand up and salute while we play the redneck. Come.
music to his cattle as he swing. Back and forward in the saddle on the horse, pretty good horse. The syncopated giddy, all to hear the music to the roar of his repeat out of the rock. When they hear him come, because the western folks all know he's highfalutin', rootin' tootin', son of a gun from Hawaii. I'm the ragtime cowboy, talk about your cowboy, ragtime cowboy, joy.
Been the all-time bestseller in Western swing, and here's the fellow that made it popular once again.
The very handsome Paul Aaron.
Well, thank you very much. You would hardly know by some of the music, but thank you, Bob Price.
It's nice to have you with us. We're talking to Paul Aaron, who is really the star of a New York radio show called Cowboy Joe's Radio Ranch, and he's very pleasantly surprised us the other day and stopped in to say hello, and we've had him with us for a couple of days, and we thought we'd play some of your music that's so popular back in New York anyway. Huh?
Well, just think, if it's popular back there, it might even be popular out here, where a lot of this music was popular.
Yeah. Tell us about some of the stuff we heard when we first started off there. The first one was Patsy Montana.
Okay, what I usually do is go back, Bob, backtrack. So let's tell you what we just heard. We heard, of course, those of you who are Wyoming alumni know that that was Cowboy Joe.
Sure.
Performed by the Wyoming Cowboy Band. However, it wasn't recorded here in Wyoming. It was recorded in 1986 at the NIT basketball tournament in New York City, recorded at Madison Square Garden by yours truly, who was sitting or standing, holding his ears in the Wyoming cheering section, and Wyoming brought their band to New York and was quite a hit. It was pretty funny watching the Wyoming fans after the game kind of pour into the streets of Manhattan wearing their Bucking Bronco jackets and everything. It was a marvelous time.
It was a good year for the team.
It was a good trip. And before Cowboy Joe, we heard Ragtime Cowboy Joe. Now that was recorded by Johnny Dennis and his Ranchers. And that's an Australian band, whether you could guess or not, that was recorded from an old 78 in the early 1940s. And Ragtime Cowboy Joe was not written for the Wyoming Cowboys, no.
Yeah.
Ragtime Cowboy Joe was written back in 1912 in Brooklyn, New York, by a New York vaudeville songwriting team. And that song, indeed, was very popular all over the country back in the 30s and 40s. And so that was my theme song in New York. That was my trademark.
Mm-hmm.
And before that, we heard a really upbeat song called I'm Gonna Be a Cowboy by Marty Robbins, recorded in Nashville back in the 1960s. And we opened up with the first million-dollar seller for a female country performer, Patsy Montana, with the Prairie Ramblers, recorded in Chicago back in 1935, I Wanna Be a Cowboy's Sweetheart. 1935. Those of you who thought Dolly Parton always had the biggest hit, that's not true. Patsy Montana had the biggest hit for a female country artist back in 1935.
Huh.
Bob, let's give out the phone number for those of you who want to call. First of all, this is a Western music program as opposed to what you might call a country music program. If you're used to hearing country music, this is a form of country music, but it's really Western music, Western swing, cowboy, honky-tonk music, which has a Western theme. And if you're enjoying the music, I can't really play your request unless I just happen to hit the song by chance. But if you'd like to call up and let me know how you're enjoying the program, then you can call us at area code 307 if you're listening outside of Wyoming, if you happen to be listening up in Alaska, Mexico, the provinces of Canada, L.A., San Francisco, even in Wyoming. Give us a call at 307-26-50,000 or 265-0000. Give us a call and let us know how you're enjoying the program.
It is 19 minutes after the hour 7. We'll be back with Paul Aaron and Cowboy Joe's Radio Ranch in just a flash.
Your planting tip from Meadow Acres Greenhouse is to plant perennials and plants that like it cool. If you have a difficult spot where nothing will grow, try perennials for ground cover or herbs to spice up your gourmet cooking. Meadow Acres carries 200 varieties of perennials that thrive in this area. Plant strawberries for ground cover and have berries in just a few weeks. Try asparagus, rhubarb, onions, and potato sets. Drive 11 miles east on the Old Glen Rock Highway, turn north on the Lazy 8 and follow the signs to Meadow Acres Greenhouse, open 8 to 8 every day.
Are you heading to or through Cheyenne? One stop to make is Little America. 190 rooms await you, an elegant dining room, a bar and lounge, with live nightly entertainment, a 24-hour coffee shop, and a full-service station with 59 pumps. Little America has easy on, easy off access on the West Lincoln Way exit at the junction of I-80 and I-25. No matter which direction you're going to get to Cheyenne, be sure to stop at Little America. There's no better choice.
Discover it all.
Do you love a big kitchen? So does Country Charm, and they've expanded their kitchen selection with more gourmet food items, bread boxes, teapots, salt and pepper mills, and the Magnolite professional line of pans. And here's an offer that's sure to get a rise out of you. Stop in during the antique show at the mall and receive a sourdough starter kit absolutely free from Country Charm.
20 minutes after 7 on the Cowboy Joe's Radio Ranch. What happened in New York when you played the Western music? What kind of response did you get?
Well, I got a good response equally from New Yorkers who knew something about the music or who just discovered it, as well as people from outside New York who live and work and suffer. I mean, who live and work in New York like I do, and who, you know, hear this music and they think of back home, whether it's Texas or Wyoming. In fact, I had a number of listeners from the Cheyenne area. I don't recall anyone from Casper, but there are people who actually have the nerve to live in New York who are from Wyoming.
Yeah.
I've gone horseback riding with them, and it's been a trip.
The radio station that Paul worked with was WKCR FM in New York City, which was a public radio station, right?
Right. Yeah. So it was public radio, and I could essentially play and say what I wanted, and I enjoyed it, but Bob, one thing you have to ask me is about my musical horn.
Oh, on the car? Well, I've heard that. Did you finish programming it? Paul was up at the K2 garage sale over the weekend, and just before he went up, he's purchased a car, one of those cars that has a little Maverick symbol on it, and how's it working?
Well, I have a musical horn, Bob, which it programs Cowboy Joe when I press a button, and it blares.